What is up, YouTube? It's your boy, TheWalk71, replaced day with a 4, and I am here with another story time for you guys. Now, this one, I've been saving for a long time. It's like I've had it in my cards, you know, ready to pull it out. Pause. Ready to pull it out at any time, you know, like a ace. So I just had to pull this out because I ran out of ideas. I'm trying to come up with some ideas for some new videos. That's why you haven't seen any videos recently, and also been very busy. But that's an excuse. I'm just gonna get right into it. So this video, I'm gonna be talking about a very special Saturday night back in 2014, I believe. It was the summer right after I graduated 8th grade, and I had my friend come over, one of my homies I grew up with, kind of. I'm not gonna put his name out there. We're just gonna call him Reggie. We're gonna call him Reggie, all right? So me and Reggie came over to my house on Friday. You know, we just played 2K, UFC, this, that, and the other. And then Saturday came, and we was like, dang, what we gonna do, bro? And I was like, I don't even know what we can do. My stepmom came downstairs because she saw that we weren't doing nothing. You know, she is really big on us not just sitting around doing nothing all day, especially. She's not really on it when I'm by myself, but when I have guests over and I'm literally sitting around not doing anything, then she'll try to find something. So she came up with a couple things. I think she said, go to the water park, but I ain't trying to do that. And something else. And then she said, let's go. Y'all want to go to the Markham roller rink? And I was like, it just brings back memories, bro. Because at the Markham roller rink, it's a roller rink and stuff, you know, like I guess Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Sunday, it's a regular average roller rink. But on Saturdays was the day that, sheesh, Saturdays was the days, you know, that's what people would like to call juke jams these days. If you know the Chance the Rapper song and you've actually experienced one, then the song really speaks true to life. Anyway, so it was a Saturday, and, you know, me and Reggie was like, all right, let's get it. We said, yeah, let's go to the roller rink, because we knew about it. She didn't. That's a good thing, right? Not really. But so she thought we were skating, gave us some money, because for some odd reason, you got to pay to get in. I mean, I understand why, but I mean, they was charging some high prices per person. I think it might have been $8 or $10. I don't even remember. I think it should be $5 per person, whatever. And the funny part is, I think the people know that it's like people in the back juking and stuff in the dark, but they just don't care because they truly don't care. I don't know, man. But the Saturday came around, bro. We went there and we got there mad early. We got there about an hour early. So, you know, me and him had to sit down at one of the tables because right next to the juke jam area, I guess, if you walk out of it, it's a dining area, because they serve food too, because they want to make sure you stay hydrated and you stay nourished while you're getting juked. So we were sitting here talking about game plan, what we gonna do, this, that, and other. This man Reggie, bro, he's hilarious. This guy was out here talking about trying to give us fake profiles. I'm all, yeah, man, we from Miami, bro. We just visiting from Chicago, one of our cousins, this, that, and other. I'm like, dude, chill. We ain't even gotta do all that. You talking about lying to people and saying we from this, bro. Like, I don't even know anything about Miami like that, except for the heat and stuff. You tweaking. So he said, whatever. So we was literally there for a good hour just waiting. And then we just literally walked around because it was nothing else to do. For some odd reason, they have specific times, because they will legitimately not start before, I believe it might have been 8 o'clock, maybe. I don't remember what time it started, but I just remember we was like an hour early and we just literally walked around. People, it was like maybe 10 people actually roller skating that day. Everybody else was in the back, bro. It was lit, bro. It was lit. So me and Reggie were just walking around the house. We was walking around the the roller rink, and then finally it was time, right? It got dark because we was walking in that area and the lights were on. So you know when the lights are off, it's time. It's time. And we go in there and it just goes crazy, bro. Left side, I see on the left side of my face, I see people getting juiced. Right side, this, that, and other people getting juiced. And I'm like, wow, bro, this already starting. And the weird part about it is this is how bad parents are now these days in Chicago. I seen little girls. I seen little girls out here juking people with, like, I guess that was their age, or they juke older people because people are pedophiles these days. So I seen a girl, she had glasses, she looked 12. I made sure I stayed about a million yards away from her, bro, because I'm not being associated with that. Like, they out here starting these chicks young, bro. I bet you that chick finna have a kid by the time she's like 15, bro, because she it's not cool, bro. Like, you shouldn't let your kids do that. You should, like, check up on your kids and make sure they don't do something like that. I mean, maybe for me, you know, I was 14, and like now I'm 16, and I know I have more knowledge. But this chick, she might have been, I don't know, no, 12, no, she was way younger than 12. She might have been maybe 8, 9, 10, 11, around that age range. She probably still watched SpongeBob. She watches SpongeBob by day, juice people by night. It's weird. Anyway, we go in there and we do our thing. You know, we split up basically. We can't. That was one thing from the game plan that we actually agreed on, was splitting up. I'll infiltrate this side and you'll infiltrate this side. It's like a, I guess you could say it was like we're doing a mission in like CSGO or, what's that game? Rainbow Six Siege. We're infiltrating sides and doing a mission. So I think he had the right, I had the left, and we just squatter around. The weird part about it, it's really dark in there. Like, it's very dark and secluded. The only lights that were in there were the lights from the DJ, and that was it. It was nothing else, and maybe a light from the hallway that led into the locker room for people to like change their skates and stuff, but that was legitimately it, bro. It is dark in there, you don't see nobody. So these chicks will legitimately juke anybody just because they can't see a face, so they just do it. It's crazy, bro. It's weird, bro. I don't know, bro. Like, I don't understand how the people who work there don't like do nothing about it. They out here got 10-year-olds juking people and stuff, and like and I'm like, how do you just let this happen, bro? Can't you go to jail for this or something? But I ain't gonna say nothing. So, you know, this, that, and other, you know, I got juked a couple times. Homie Reggie got juked. Funny story was, it was this one part where we accidentally met each other out of nowhere. We accidentally met each other on a wall, right? And the crazy part was, he was getting juked by this chick, and I was just waiting for somebody. And this is why Reggie's the homie. He told the chick, hey, go get my homie right next to me. And she instantly did what he said. I guess she treated him like a pimp, bro, because she instantly got him on me. I was like, oh, okay, let's get it. You know, I wasn't like that, but, you know, it was a cool experience. You know, shouts out to Reggie. You know, he the homie. He probably won't know that it's him, but shouts out to Reggie, even though that's not his name. Another funny part is, we met somebody that we graduated 8th grade with. I don't know what to call him. We gonna call that man Aiden. I don't know. These names are weird. We gonna call him Aiden. It was Aiden and his homie. We graduated 8th grade. We was cool. Another funny story is that earlier in the 8th grade, he had a party, and it was at that same place, and it was the same function and event. And this man loves going there. He talks about going all the time. This man literally goes there every Saturday night because he's not that far away from me. So we talked to him. We was talking about, what up, dude? He's all linking up, you know, trying to, you know, catch up on what happened, because it's only been a couple months after we graduated 8th grade. And I knew after that, I probably was not going to be talking to them forever. I still kind of on and off with them, except for Reggie. That's the homie. But Aiden, I haven't talked to him since that event. You know, he's probably followed me on Twitter and I followed back or whatever, but that's pretty much it. So we just lived it up, you know, man, it was cool. The dance then was the Nene. That was the dance back in 2014, not the dab and the whip and the what's the other one, the drop, you know, the yeet, all the other stuff. No, that didn't exist back then. No, the yeet was just starting by the time that happened, and we was just nay-naying, bro. It was fun, bro. It was a good time. It was a time where you can get juke by a chick, you can get tea with your homies, footworking and stuff. It was a fun thing, man. It really, I guess, a Chicago juke jam really brings people together. I didn't think that was possible, but it just was. So after that, you know, the funny part is they want to make sure that you're, like I said earlier, they want to make sure that you are, you know, very hydrated and what's the word I'm looking for? Nourished, like you ate and you drank, because they have an intermission halfway. Yeah, man. You can get you a taco, you can get you some chicken, get you pizza, you can get you a nice little coat, sit back, get you a towel, because it stank up in there because people were sweating, and some of these chicks stink, bruh. I'm sorry, but some people were stinking, bruh. But anyway, you can sweat off, you can get a paper towel, wipe your face, because people were sweating, bro. I was sweating. It was hot in there too. It was no AC or nothing, bro. They want you to die because it smelled like onions on some of these chicks and some of these people, bro. It's weird. So after we finished eating, this, that, and the other, went back in, you know, got juked a little bit more, and then it was over. That's the worst part about it, when they say it's over. So me and Reggie walked out. My stepmom was parked in the front. I was dapping it up with the homies, and we all said bye. We'll talk later, but we never even talked again. Got back in the crib, right? She drove off, and she was talking about, dang, these girls out here are really out here, because the chicks who was like out here, that's probably our age, either older, they was dressing like some straight hoes, bro. Like, I'm gonna be honest, bro, they had, you know, the little shorts, not even like the ones that are like, because like they have a cheek hanging out, bro. Like, it's ridiculous how some of these chicks be walking out the house, and how their parents just be letting them. They be having midriffs. Some of them are just wear like a very like short tank top or shirt. Like, they are ready to get the D from somebody, bro, because they had they booty cheeks hanging out. It's just weird, bro. Some of these chicks be walking out, and she was talking about that. Like, some of these girls dress out here like they growing. They young. This, that, and other. And then me and Jaren, we had gave a look to each other, like, yeah, man, we did our thing out there. So then, you know, we came back, ate some food, because we didn't eat at the thing, ironically, played some 2K, went to sleep. The next day, we went across the street, because across the street from my father's house is a park. And the funny thing about that park is nobody's there. That's the crazy part. This is literally a playground for children to get on swings and go down slides, and nobody's there. So we just made that our designated, you know, talk spot, because it's a bench over there where you can sit down and talk, and it is a baseball field too. So we just was talking, you know, recapping the whole night. And, you know, I was like, yeah, man, you know, I got me a couple things, you know, this one chick, jeez, bro, it was lit, bro. I don't want to talk about everything, you know, but it was a very lit time. Then he started talking. I think Reggie got a girl's number, I don't know. And then I told him about the young chicks, the little 10-year-old SpongeBob watching girls who was in there. And I was talking about, hey, you seen that chick, bro? She had on glasses. She like mad little. She like a little girl. He was talking about, yeah, man. He said, I got some from her. I was, what? He said, yeah, man, I got some from her. I said, bro, do you realize she's like 10 and you like 14, bro? I don't think you should be doing that, bro. Don't, please, dog, bro. That's some pedo stuff, bro. I was just like so surprised. This man really was like, he wanted the booty. He didn't care what age the chick was. He just wanted the booty. Hopefully I talk some sense to him so that he doesn't want the booty when he's like 30 and the chick is like 15. Hopefully. Anyway, guys, that was the lit Saturday night. I don't even know what I'm gonna call this. Like, comment, favorite, subscribe, do what you do to support me. I got stuff coming soon, bro. I got this 2K video coming out. I just have to edit it. It's hard to edit, bro. I have never really gotten to serious editing, so this is kind of hard for me to do. It's gonna come out soon though. You gonna enjoy it. I know that you gonna enjoy it. I might be streaming this weekend because I'm going to be staying at one location that will allow me to keep all of my streaming recording devices. So expect to stream maybe Friday, Saturday. I don't know. I don't even know when this video is going to come out. Hopefully soon. Everything I just said, like, comment, favorite, subscribe. Follow me on all of my social media sites down in the description below. Anyway, guys, I'm out. Peace.